This place is great, really comfortable. I'm just gonna get settled in. Time to move on. Get on with my life. Yes, absolutely. Now, like I said, it was a long time ago. Let it go. Seriously. Definitely more my style than Panama, or Hoboken, I guess. No, if I'm honest, I just got kind of bored of boozing. I mean, once in a while, but not all the time. You're right, it wasn't doing me any favors. Maybe I'd lost my self-respect, but it's back. I'm excited. Really. I really needed a new start. I think you're right. I think I am gonna like it here. It certainly ain't New Jersey. It's my new life. Just like you said. Listen, if you think I can still do a job, what have I got to lose? Apart from the weight. Very funny, ha ha. Yes, that is a fake laugh, you jerk. So I guess I'd become what they wanted me to be. A killer. Some rent-a-clown with a gun who puts holes in other bad guys. Well, that's what they had paid for, so in the end, that's what they got. Say what you want about Americans, but we understand capitalism. You buy yourself a product and you get what you pay for. And these chumps had paid for some angry gringo without the sensibilities to know right from wrong. Here I was, about to execute this poor bastard like some dime store angel of death. And I realized they were correct. I wouldn't know right from wrong if one of them was helping the poor and the other was banging my sister. I'd arrived in São Paulo a few weeks before, I was working a protection detail for the kind of people who need protection in a town like this. And what kind of town was this? One where I didn't speak the language and they didn't water down their drinks. So for now, we seemed to get along just fine. Of course, that was about to change.
Hey, brother.
Hey.
How's the cocktail?
Scotch. I never mix my drinks.
Well, at least not on duty.
Something like that.
Man, that favela is big.
Yep. Nothing like the view of extreme poverty to make a penthouse cocktail party really swing.
I guess they call it trickle-down economics.
That's funny.
It's supposed to be a charity thing. Drink and give money. I don't know. Something for the kids. Hey, listen, man. We better look lively. This place is a nightmare. You just got cowboys running security downstairs. Something rotten in the air.
That didn't mean much. There was always something rotten in the air. The family we were protecting were local celebrities, rich parasites with delusions of humanity. The kind of people who end up in glossy magazines or body bags, depending on how their luck runs.
So where are they all? I see Rodrigo over there talking to that guy.
Yeah, I don't know him. That guy next to him, he's some kind of cop. I'm not sure. Serious, though. Big end cop, anti-gang sort of thing. I can't remember his name.
So who's this guy?
That guy's a plastic surgeon or some kind of surgeon. Tummy tucks and cock implants. Ha! Look at Marcel. Still dances like a fool.
Guess that's what a European education and a coke habit will do for Ricky Martin look alike.
That's very funny, Max. Oh, excuse me.
I was mostly working for Rodrigo Branco, a local businessman. Built things, did some charity, had things named after him, won awards, owned things, people. One of the trophies he had won was his wife, Fabiana. She was hot and wanted to be dangerous. Some good genes trying to fight their way out of a cesspit. She'd married well and was now at leisure to regret her good fortune. They got along as well as any rich workaholic and his younger airhead wife tend to get along. They mostly ignored each other. She spent a lot of time with his cokehead younger brother, Marcello. He was a good time guy if your idea of a good time was an expensive suit, a bottle of champagne, and nothing between the ears. The middle brother, Victor, had just walked in. He was a local politician. Guy was smoother than an oil slick on an iceberg and about as toxic. The rest of the crowd, I didn't know, but I could imagine the types. People who know if they drink enough, they won't have to feel guilty about their good fortune. Suddenly, things turned real ugly. Felt like our hangovers arrived right on cue.
What the hell was that?
I don't know what the fuck that was. Let's go.
Things had gone from fine to fucked up in about a second. And now there were two idiots at the wheel.
Clear. Got this floor?
Sure.
Right, look after yourself, bro. Stay safe.
It wasn't my own safety I was concerned about. Trophy wife or not. I'd said I would protect the girl.
Don't be stupid! Let her go! Come on!
It might have been stupidity, drunkenness, or maybe both. But before I knew it, I was back taking insane risks, trying to save fallen women.
Tranquila! Nós cuidamos disso!
Nice work! Hey, you need a hand?
No, you? Where the hell's Rodrigo?
I don't know, man. Thanks.
Somebody's gotta go find him.
Está tudo sob controle agora. Fica tranquilo.
I imagined the elevator doors opening to a firing squad of muzzles. Far as I could see it, the one thing my plan had going was that no one else would be stupid enough to pull this move. Rodrigo was too rich a prize for them to throw away. Sure, I'd have to work hard to get him back, but I knew the bad guys would want the boss alive, almost as much as I did.
Falando com meus homens assim.
Você acha que tem o direito de matar as pessoas a sangue frio, Becker?
Cala a boca, cuzão! Continua dando multas. Não põe o nariz onde não é chamado. Vamos!
Ai, ajuda, cara.
Chama uma ambulância!
Ajuda.
Fuck.
You did good, Max.
You say so. Don't look so good.
Hey, what could be better, huh? The good guys are reunited, and the Commando Sombra are dead.
I guess. So who's this guy?
I don't know. Some kind of cop. Different branch of the police. Not UFE, but normal cops. I don't know about this stuff. Politics. Everywhere politics. Shit, Max, you look kind of beat up. Let's get this lot home, and then I'll get you home, too. Come on.
Back home, it was time for some R&R, the only way I knew how. I was ready for bed. A couple of days later, it was back to work, ferrying the boss's broad and his dipshit of a brother out for the night so they could recover from their brush with mortality. Then again, what did I expect? These were the kind of people who went to nightclubs in helicopters. Fabiana had brought her sister along, presumably so she could show off just how rich and empty her life was. And boy, was she about to learn the meaning of rich and empty.
Max! Max! I was speaking to you!
Sorry, what was that?
Oh, I was saying we get into a lot of scrapes, man!
Well, we're still here.
Hey!
Thanks to you, Max! I owe you my life.
Boom. It wasn't just him, huh, baby?
Oh, yes, Marcel. I'm sure you did a lot to save everyone. You were probably worried about getting blood on your stash.
Very funny.
Thank you, Max. I don't know what I would do without my sister.
We'd spend even more time doing something useful. You know she works in the favela.
She's the good sister.
Oh, shut up.
What did you hear, Faba? More bodies turned up or people went missing. But it's horrifying.
Did someone say Buzz Q?
Hey.
I'm just kidding. But it is a cool town, man. Hey, here we are.
Saúde!
Saúde!
I love this view. It's a real chill place to hang, you know? Do a little business, have some fun. I need it too. I've been working far too hard. Like a whore during Fleet Week, as my roommate used to say. You like that, Max?
That's pretty funny.
I'm glad you are still with us. Come, I heard what happened. I've missed you. I would have called,
okay.
But you know how it is. Didn't want it to bother you.
Okay.
Hey, Marcel. Marcel, I think I might have an interesting investment for your brother.
Well, call him up, homie.
I haven't seen him for a while.
Of course.
Last week was Fashion Week. My God, Egypt, but so beautiful. You know Anastasia?
Oh, yeah, I know Anna.
This kind of place made me want to puke. I needed a real drink to deal with the electronic music and the robotic people.
Fucking monkey from a fucking slum. He acts cool with me.
What's that?
Nothing. Say, Max, you're a man of the world. What do you fucking do it, man?
About what?
What do you do about life?
Look at me, I'm standing in a nightclub. Listening to music I can't stand. I'm 5,000 miles from home. I'm armed and I'm drinking. You don't want to listen to advice from me, amigo.
Oh, Max, I love you, man. You're fucking real, you know? Oh, shit. People. Fuck them. People get me wrong. I think I love a wrong woman. Oh, excuse me. Fabio! Fabio! Ah, my nigga!
Thank God he has left. A minute more of his drivel and I would have to put a bullet in him myself. It soon turned out I wasn't the only one. Doors had been chained shut. I didn't need my Portuguese for beginners phrase book to work out what was going on. The guy making the noise was the boss.
He was sending them around to cut me off from the other side. And sure enough, a few seconds later, I had some company on the dance floor.
Hey, São Paulo's favorite bodyguard. How's it going, bro?
It's not good. Some guys took Giovanna and Fabiana.
What? Jesus, Max. Hey, I'm on my way.
No. Stay in the chopper. We'll need a way out of here. I'll go find the girls.
God, they came out there. They went that way into the lounge.
Come here.
Go.
Get up. You can't stay here. I need you to lock this door behind me. Get everybody else out of here.
They were still alive, at least. This crew was starting to look a lot like friends of the gatecrashers at last week's party. These guys had some real issues with the Broncos. They were headed for the helicopter pad. I had to get to the roof before Giovanna and Fabiana left on a one-way flight. I knew this was going to be a bad idea, but in the continued absence of any good ones, I decided to go with it. What a view. I guess my time in São Paulo wasn't quite the paid holiday in the sun I'd been promised. At least I was getting shot at by a better class of psychopath. These guys weren't messing around. This place was like Baghdad with G-strings. A couple of more seconds and I'd have given some poor street cleaner a crappy start to his day. Now, I had a ride to catch.
All I said!
Come on! Jesus, Max! I can't leave you alone for 5 minutes! What the hell happened in there?
They jumped us! Same guys from the party, I think. They grabbed the girls and Marcelo, but he's here now.
Yeah, don't worry about me, homie. I'm just the guy paying you lots of money to protect me.
Yeah, what were you drinking?
Bet your ass I was. You try staying in there for 5 minutes sober.
Oi, olha!
Oh, there they are!
Quick, get after them! Are you crazy? You can't just leave her! Max, you gotta do something! Come on! Get the rifle back there!
He's making a run for it!
Hey, hold on! Bring it around!
Move! You're gonna lose her! Move, you're gonna lose her!
She's headed for the roof! Gotta get around this thing!
How is this getting around it? I am empty! Oh, look! There she is there!
This is the guy! To point you!
Do something!
She's headed inside, Passos! Get us down there!
Right! I'm headed to the helipad!
There was a goddamn army of these goons. Clearly, somebody wanted these girls bad. Or maybe they just assumed the Broncos security team consisted of more than a drunk American has-been and a Brazilian never-was who should have paid more attention in flying school.
Giovanna! Giovanna!
Max! Over here! What's happening? Where were you?
Are you all right?
But do I look all right?
Don't worry, we're gonna get you out of here.
Passos, where is he? Is he okay?
I had to make a quick detour. He's fine. He's right there.
My God, it's Raul!
Giovanna!
Raul!
What are you doing?
Giovanna! Hey! No, nothing. Go.
Seems like I wasn't the only guy around here who had taken his eye off the ball.
Are you okay?
My weakness was the drink. Passos was the sister. Things were turning pretty ugly in this town. The boss's girl was gone, and part of me wished I was too.
Thank you.
Well, what choice do we have?
We have never paid out ransoms before. But I don't know. I don't like the feeling of this. What about you, Max?
I don't know. I'm no expert on hostage negotiations. I know people who are, but they're in America.
We don't have time for America.
I know you're right, Marcelo. It's not like I don't have the money to pay.
Father made a lot of money. We have always been targets. We all know that. But much as it pains me, I don't see we have a choice. Maybe after we pay, we find out who did it. We have them. But we all know what I'm saying.
Who do you think is targeting your family?
Haters.
Who can say? Life in this country is not easy, you can see that. I have tried to do business the right way, but that's not always possible. Of course I made enemies, but I've also paid a lot of bribes. I have no idea.
It's probably that street gang trying to get at me.
I don't know. People I know have tried to reach out to this group. Comando Sombra. They're not from any of the favelas around here. They're linked to the drug business. Now, what have I got to do with drugs? Nothing.
Everybody loves money.
I just want my wife back.
We can take the money to them.
Sem fazer barulho, sem fazer cagada, hein?
Estou ali, pô! Ei, vocês aí, parado, pela puta!
Ei,
ei! Calma.
Parado aí! Parado aí, garoto de merda! Bota essa arma no chão!
Hey, put the gun down, put down your gun.
Bota essa arma no chão agora!
Slow, slow, slow.
Não faça nada, estúpido! Me mostra o dinheiro!
What's he saying?
Open the bag, show me it's full of money.
Depressa, porra, depressa!
Easy, pal, easy.
Vem!
Apparently, someone up in the nosebleeds didn't like the game we were playing. The money was gone, and I was next if I didn't get off that field.
You okay?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. There's gotta be a first aid kit around here somewhere.
I've been shot more times than I could remember. But this felt different. Maybe fate was sending me a message, trying to tell me my luck was finally about to run out. Or maybe I just severed an artery and was bleeding out like any number of fools who got shot playing with guns. Either way, I was failing fast.
The guy with the bag must have got hit. He's bleeding all over the place.
He's not the only one. Come on. I think he went this way.
Ow.
Whoa. Looks like I missed all the fun.
You see there, Grandpa? Come on. I'm getting flashbacks to that wedding we worked in Aruba.
Yeah. Back to the good old days when I thought I might actually like this job.
Dumb sport.
Hey, careful, my friend. That's blasphemy in this town. You okay, bro?
Never better. Whose idea was this anyway?
Yeah, I wonder. Is it bad?
A lot worse.
Here.
Thank you.
Right. Here we go. Put the sleeve up, come on. All right, don't be a pussy.
So what now?
We make sure that the right clowns get the money.
Who the hell do you think that was? Tried to gatecrash our little wine and cheese party.
I have no idea. This is São Paulo, brother. Could be anyone.
Anyone with access to high-powered sniper rifles and trained killers.
That's pretty much everyone.
Great. So what now, Einstein?
Well, I guess we get this Comando Sombra their money.
And make sure they know we did not try to trick them otherwise. Fabiana, she won't come back in such good shape.
Puta. Caralho, mano, não faço ideia, foi uma cilada, cara. Nós precisamos sair daqui, vamos vazar, vamos, vamos.
Onde é essa aí?
Come on, come on.
Eu sabia que essa porra ia dar merda. Quem foi o filho da puta que teve essa ideia de tarde?
Cala a boca, porra, se concentra, caralho.
He's freaking out, it's real. So what am I, the button pusher?
Yeah. So good at it. Good job.
Just another day at the office, huh?
You should have known this wouldn't end well.
Didn't even begin well. It was hardly a textbook hostage exchange.
I guess I must have skipped that class. Okay, come on. Let's go.
It didn't sound like we were the only ones getting shot at. Who the hell had tipped these guys off? I didn't know what to think anymore. This town had more smoke and mirrors than a strip club locker room.
Aqui, cara. Vamos lá. Não, aqui. Por aqui. Essa porta aqui. Fecha a porta depressa. Rápido.
Pariu!
Ei, peraí. Não me deixa aqui sozinho.
O que, seu viado do caralho? Cadê a porra do dinheiro? Cadê uma bala na sua cabeça, filha da puta?
Hein? Hein, morre, favelado, filha da puta!
Eles devem ter ido por aqui.
Abre a porta.
They seem nice enough.
Sai! Sai, vamos, pega os caras, pega os caras!
Are they cops?
You tell me. I don't think so.
Caralho, porra! Puta que pariu!
Come on, they're going after the cash. I've had enough of these fools.
Pega!
Giving him his last rites, don't you think?
Look at this flapjack. This is high-end gear. These guys are seriously financed.
Yeah, I noticed. I'll get you one for Christmas. Come on, let's keep moving.
We've still got a sniper on us.
We'll deal with him first. I only got one shoulder left.
There's no time. The money will be long gone. We gotta stay on the guy with the bag. That guy was getting annoying.
What the hell did they know about the exchange?
This is Sampa, bro. That kind of cash doesn't stay quiet for long. And these kids are like expensive toys. Here, put this on. Now, a better chance if we split up.
This looks like we know what we're doing.
Yeah, right. Don't speak too soon, brother.
Looks like it's coming from the stands.
Shit, they got the guy with the bag.
Stay here. Cover me. I'll go after him.
Hey, keep your headset on. Where are you headed?
I'm going up. I don't know. Guess I'm nowhere nice.
Was any of the money?
Nope. Just people shooting at me. Our surprise guest brought a lot of friends. All right. In the upper stands.
I see you.
How's it looking, Max?
It's all clear up here.
What about the kid with the money?
I don't even... Must be still in this section.
Wait! Hang on.
What's happening, Passos?
Shit.
There's a whole gang up ahead of my way. I'm almost out of ammo and rope.
Making a run for it.
All right, try to clear you some space.
I'm going back in, bro. You're kidding me.
locked.
Try the other side.
I'm clear, Max. Damn, bro. That wasn't fun.
Listen to me. You head for the chopper. We need to be ready to get the hell out of here. I guess I'll stay on the money.
Sounds like a plan.
Bit late for a plan, pal.
God damn it!
Max?
Shit. Now we got another sniper on me. So let me deal with this guy first.
All right, bro. I'm moving too. Stay in touch.
Place was like Fort Knox.
Hey, Passos. Passos. I've got you on the security camera. Where are you?
I don't know. Somewhere in this goddamn stadium. Oh, Jesus.
What's going on there?
I think the guys that came to rob us are coming to finish the job.
Remind me again, who are these fine gentlemen?
Some kind of paramilitaries. I don't know.
Paramilitaries?
Right-wing guns for hire, ex-cops, military. I don't know. They can handle weapons.
What's going on now?
The guy's pleading for his life. He's saying that Fabiana is being held at the docks of the Chete River. Oh, Jesus, they shot him.
Well, there goes the money. Now we've lost the wife and $3 million. The boss will be giving us a raise at this rate.
Yeah, that's messed up, all right. Come on. Out of this place. Take care of that guy in the IT tower. I'll meet you at the chopper.
I'm gonna make a run for the light rig.
I had a hole in my second favorite drinking arm, and the only way we were likely to get Fabiana back now was in installments.
Okay, I'm going up.
Good. Make it quick.
Believe me, I ain't gonna drag this out.
We'd half destroyed Sao Paulo's most hallowed place of worship. Looking back, it was strange how the cops never showed up. But things had a habit of only making sense to me, looking back long after I'd run out of time to fix them.
Make an entrance, bro. Now let's get the hell out of here.
Us the same way you found me, slumped in a bar, drunk on self-pity. I'd tried not to think about when it was that my existence became less about the things that make up people's lives and more about the holes that losing those things leave behind. But I wasn't doing a very good job at it.
Oh, hey, hey. Women.
I need to get laid,
put the
baby.
Music up! We're here!
These pricks had been annoying me for days. They were typical Jersey rich kids. The ringleader, I think his name was Tony. His dad was some well-known hood, drug dealer, racketeer, pillar of the New Jersey community.
Line them up, line them up, line them up.
Let me ask you a question.
Let's go.
Where the fuck are your donuts?
This kid had a well-developed sense of humor for New Jersey.
Seriously? I thought I told you to get out of here, old man.
Yeah, old man.
Nice echo. Gorillas have personalities of their own, or they just agree with everything you say.
Very funny, old man. Very
fucking
funny.
That's hilarious.
Yeah, has been washed up old cops. You go on TV. Yeah. Tell some jokes about how you got your wife killed or some shit.
Yeah, where's the little old lady?
Or how you got involved with killers. I own this town, amigo.
That's a good line. Practice that in front of the mirror in your underwear? Your father owns this town. Yeah, dear old dad, well-known drug dealer and murderer. You're nothing but a chump.
Hey, don't disrespect my family. You ain't got the right.
Hey, don't take that from this punk.
I ain't taking nothing from him. God hasn't already deprived him of. But I might start anytime. Now say you're sorry.
Say you're sorry.
Has been caught, motherfucker. Say you are sorry.
Say you're fucking sorry.
Look away from me. Look away from me. Don't you stare at me. Say you're sorry.
Listen to him.
Which you want first?
Don't act clever, you fucking leather jacket dipshit cop cunt. Don't act clever. I will blow your brains all over this counter, every fucking where.
Come on, Tony. Calm down.
Don't fuck with me, Marty. I'll shoot you as well. Don't fuck with me.
Marty, he ain't fucking kidding.
Put the gun down, son.
Who the fuck is this?
Put the gun down now.
Hey.
Thank you. Now get the fuck out of here before anyone gets shot.
I got you.
Who the fuck are you?
I got you.
Don't worry about it.
Fuck.
Go on. I'm gonna fuck off.
Get you, motherfucker.
Coming back for you, you fuck.
I look forward to it.
Yeah?
Stay right here. Stay right here. You don't know who you're fucking with.
Yeah, whatever.
Max fucking Payne. How you doing, man?
Doing about as good as I look.
You don't remember me?
Pasos. How pasos? Come on, we went to the academy together, man. You don't remember?
That's going back a long way, French.
I spent 5 years on the beat in the Bronx, working homicides. I nearly got killed, man. I gave up. I got into private work. Here, Central America, Brazil, where my family comes from. All over.
Ah, that's great. Travel, see the world.
Yeah, keeps me busy. I take care of people, you know? Proper bodyguarding. Hey, I'm working for a good firm. I'm actually here on a bit of a recruitment drive.
Yeah, well, why don't you drive on off back into the sunset there, Pesos? It's been nice catching up.
At least let me buy you a drink.
Yeah, sure. Anybody can buy me a drink.
All right. Two more. Look, this is the way we do it in Brazil, baby.
I had to admit, I kind of like the guy.
Hey, another round. Max is buying.
He had a great set of stories, but I still wasn't interested in becoming a white knight again.
Saúde.
Cheers.
What, I don't look like I go to Shakespeare or something?
Para
um
pouco.
Saúde!
Cheers!
You faggot still got something to say to me? Yeah. Fuck off. I don't like spicks who tell me to fuck off.
Well, good for you.
Now fuck off! Don't stare at me, whore.
Fuck you, asshole. No dick, asshole.
What'd you say?
You heard me. I'm not frightened of you, you spray-tan Guido douche. You...
Girl sure had balls. I had to give her that.
Oh, shit!
I don't know why I did it. I guess I never liked seeing girls get hit. But from that moment, I was dead in that town.
Stay cool and we might survive this.
this easy for us either.
Stay over here. Cover me.
Yes, sir. He could have been setting me up for a fall. Something told me to stay put and trust him.
Right around the corner. Let's go this way.
Let's go.
The bar was right around the corner from my apartment. It only took a few minutes to get back.
It's a nice place you got here, homie.
Thanks for noticing.
Why are you living like this?
Like what?
You know, scratching around? Sitting in bars all day?
Maybe I just haven't found the right guy to put a bullet through my head yet. I just don't know.
I can get you work, Max. Work that only a guy like you can do.
Can you give me work sitting in a bar feeling sorry for myself? Where do I sign up?
Saúde.
Gesundheit.
You were the best guy in the academy. And you won medals on the street.
Hey, I lost loved ones on the street. Right? Family. More than once.
Yeah, I know. So leave. Start over. You've mourned enough.
I ain't a cop no more.
And this ain't cop work. This is protecting people in places where the cops ain't too hot.
No thanks, pal. I think I just better lay low for a while.
You, I want on the roof. You, I want on every doorway. And you guys, I want every fucking corner covered.
About that plan.
I'm coming after you, you motherfucking murdering bastard. Made 100 angry greaseballs.
Who's that?
Anthony DeMarco. He's the father of the kid I just shot.
Max Payne.
Yeah, that
Max
looks about right.
Payne! You killed my boy. You killed my only son.
We gotta get out of here now.
Are you not inviting these guys in?
When had I ever needed to invite trouble in? It always found me, no matter where I hid.
Come on.
These chumps have been chopping up cars around the corner from my apartment for the last year. The ex-cop and me clocked it months ago, but the deadbeat and me didn't give a shit.
Dead end.
You knew your way around these parts.
Let's just get over there.
Yeah? Think you need a hand?
No, do you? Go, amigo.
You like that?
Should be a bit quieter in here.
Yeah, it's nice. Yeah, I can see why you'd want to leave this place, Max. It's real charming.
Isn't it?
So look, I got some friends in Queens. We can stay there for a few days.
Queens?
Want a job yet, Max? Max? You listening? Max! So like I was saying, I think they're a group called the Crashapre.
Why'd you tell me they were called the CS?
They are. I mean, Fabiana. She was kidnapped by the CS. Guys that crashed our little party at the stadium, they were a group of paramilitaries.
You'll have to forgive me for not being able to follow all this.
You're not supposed to follow it. The government can't even follow it. It ensures that no one's ever guilty.
So why'd they do it? Bust us at the stadium.
Somebody told them we were gonna be there with a whole lot of money. Anyway, the money's gone. I just hope we can get the girl back.
Yeah, me too. I wonder where the hell she is.
You know, there's a harbor about a half a mile up. She's gotta be there. This is a known Comando Sombra area.
You know, if I'd been doing my job properly, I wouldn't be out here in the middle of nowhere looking for some broad who got pinched on my watch.
That's what we tell ourselves, huh? It's all our fault.
No, I'm serious. By the time they grabbed the girls, I was half cut. I ain't slipping, man. I'm slipped. I'm a bad joke.
Max, we work private security. We're all ex-soldiers, ex-special forces, ex-cops, ex-good guys. We all have our reasons why we became ex. Maybe now we can put things right, okay?
So that was it, was it? Say the magic word and be absolved of your sins. If only shit were that simple, I'd have done it years ago. Me, I've been stuck in the past so long, I'd forgotten what year it was.
Max, quit your daydreaming. This is it. It's over there. I'm gonna cut the engine. Light in.
Don't go anywhere.
Looked like Passos had brought us to the right place. That was the chopper the Commando Sombra used to escape the nightclub attack. That was the chair that she had been held in. I had just missed them. There they were. I had the feeling I'd been running one step behind ever since I got to this country. And maybe a few years before that as well. I was an overconfident chump going into the jungle alone.
Watch out behind us, Passos.
See it! Look out!
Another one down.
Oha! That's them, ain't it? Fabiana's throwing us in the front! We're losing! Good boy! Follow us, everyone! Keep after them!
See Fabian!
Move up, Bogdan!
Alright, alright. I'll get a little closer.
Who's in?
Come on, just give me a second. Try it, man. Shit.
Fabiana had slipped through my fingers for a second time. Another habit I didn't want or need.
It's close. We almost had her. Damn.
I don't think we ever had much of a chance. No one told us they had an entire goddamn army.
I don't think anybody knew. Crazy shit.
Yeah. It's all crazy, pal. Non-stop insanity. Thought I left all this shit behind. Easy gig, you said. What a fool I was to get involved in this madness.
bro? Max. Wake up, Max. Come on. Get up, you big bastard. Come on.
I'm up.
Yeah? You don't look up.
Just give me a second, will you? I'm really not feeling too good.
Hey, Max, what is it with you in interior design? Huh? You really know how to give a place a great lived-in feel, huh? This is beautiful.
Fuck off with the fucking wisecracks. Really, I'm not in the mood.
Okay, sorry, bro. The boss wants to see us, so let's go, come on. Take your time, man. Fucking unbelievable. Jesus.
I heard that.
Oh, give me a second. I'm not feeling so good.
Bom dia.
Alice está aí?
O que o senhor acha? Claro que sim. E o senhor bem pontual,
tudo bem.
Não?
You fucking pair of clowns!
I'm sorry, sir. We risked our lives several times over trying to save...
I know. I just wish I knew what was happening and why.
Yes. Who has it in for our family?
I mean, just because we are rich and happy. Is that a good reason to hate us? I do a lot of good in this town. A lot!
This is hell for me. As I told you yesterday, when I get Fabiana back, I think I will move us to Miami or Geneva. It feels like nothing good can come from living in São Paulo right now.
I hope you're not giving up on our city, Senor Branco. Listen, we will catch the man. You have my word on that.
Listen to Mr. Becker, brother. Yes, these are tough times, but we have been through it before. Like when father died.
Father had a heart attack visiting a brothel. Yeah, it was humiliating and embarrassing for sure. But now this is different. This is the Emperor.
Well, she's not dead. Maybe we'll be lucky and get her back safe soon.
I can almost guarantee it. If you do as I ask.
Maybe.
Be strong, brother. For your wife. I know this has been tough on you. But things will get better. For all of us. Hmm? Marcelo, pasos in my helicopter. This way.
Sure.
Mr. Becker?
Senor?
Let us give you a ride.
Bom. Até logo, Senor Branco. And may I say, you would be best served se contratar profissionais e não esses amadores pés de chinelo.
Goodbye, Mr. Becker.
Até logo, Senhor Branco.
I had so many plans, Max.
Didn't we all?
I was born into great fortune. Sometimes it feels like I have done nothing apart from being a rich man in a poor country. The men I talk to, they only see money. Now my wife. I am not naive. She does not love me for my body.
Well, despite your good fortune, you're still a decent man.
Am I? I don't know. I try to be. But maybe I'm just another rich fool, just like the rest of my friends.
Com licença. Tem uma ligação para o senhor, um policial chamado Senhor da Silva.
Ah, diga que eu ligo mais tarde.
Sim.
Another bent cop wanting a pension contribution. Do you think a pile of shit feels popular because it's surrounded by flies? Look at me. I'm a mess.
O que está acontecendo? Meu Deus! Sim, pode entrar!
Senhor, temos problema. O sistema de segurança foi desativado.
I can see that. We got men entering the building, and the office won't lock down.
Posso?
Claro que pode.
It's not working. There's a way to reboot the system. If I can get to the server room, I should be able to get everything back online.
Strange. You pay a couple million dollars, and you expect to push a button to be able to make all your problems go away. That was some useless junk and a bit of false confidence. I'm done, Max.
Sir, let us handle this. You stay in your office, lock yourself in. Do not answer the door unless you know it's me. Let's go.
I should be able to override the system if I could just get to the server room.
What's going on?
Nothing to worry about. Everything's fine. Get down behind the desk now, both of you.
Get down behind the desk, now, both of you.
Max! Max!
Yeah, it's safe, come on.
We need to get you to the server room, let's go.
Por que não posso ficar aqui com você debaixo da mesa?
Let's go, come on!
Okay, I'm coming! Come on.
This code should get us into the boardroom. Okay.
The server room is just past those cubicles.
These clowns were the same guns for hire who jumped our exchange at the stadium. Crotch a Prado, the black badge. Right-wing paramilitary chumps protecting whoever paid the most. I guess that made them more like me than I cared to admit. Were they just looking for another payday, or did their business with the Broncos run deeper?
Gonna be able to fix this or what?
In a few minutes, eh? I should be able to reboot the system, get all the components back online.
What about Bronco's office? That's all I care about.
You should be able to lock us down, eh? If this works.
Whatever you're doing, do it quick. I'm gonna make a sweep of the building and then get back to Rodrigo's.
The security system was back online. Things might be a little tougher for our fan club from here on in. Seemed like breaching the perimeter had been no more difficult than strolling through the front gates. But hey, who needs a Trojan horse when the alarm is down and your standing army is a dame, a dork, and a drunk? Bronco's office overlooked the atrium. I could check in and make sure he hadn't checked out.
Max! Your guy's working on the security system now, sir.
It just came on!
Okay, good. Then lock yourself down. Stay put. Let us take care of these guys down here. Once they realize they can't get to you, they should back off.
Max, try not to completely destroy the place.
Let's just concentrate on staying alive. Sir!
There it went. He was tucked up safe. I didn't know what the hell I was going to find up there. But I sensed it wasn't going to be a stripper bursting out of a cake.
Senor Branco! Senor Branco! I can't get through to him. Ever since the security doors triggered, he hasn't made a sound.
Rodrigo, it's Max. Open up. Can you hear me?
Eu já tentei.
Senor Branco, open up! I'm going to try to get in there from the roof. You find the security guard and get the hell out of here.
Yes.
I knew there was another way in upstairs for the helipad, the little luxury runaround that kept the rich looking down on the poor literally as well as metaphorically.
Rodrigo! Rodrigo! Rodrigo!
Of course, he was dead. Clean, one shot, a professional job. I began to look for clues. I couldn't get playback on one of the cameras, and it looked like the disc was missing. Someone in this building was trying to keep things low-key. But then why had everyone else come driving through the goddamn wall? Fabiana. Even if the man who employed me was dead, his wife was still out there. Maybe she could be saved.
Maybe some good. Picking the photo from the broken fragments, something caught my eye.
Figures.
Only blind luck it meant the blast wasn't fatal. If I'd been out for any longer, the smoke would have gotten me. Someone up ahead was hurt pretty bad. If he didn't die before I got to him, I might get some answers.
Hey! Why? Why Rodrigo Branco? Why did you come to kill Rodrigo Branco?
Came to kill you! Because what you did to us! You killed so many of us!
What reason did this poor bastard have to lie? He would be dead from shock or loss of blood in half an hour, even if I didn't leave him there to burn.
Where's Fabiana?
What?
Fabiana Branco, where is she?
La Comando Sombra got her. Up the hill.
And it was up the hill for me, I guess, where the gang held sway. I had to try to figure out who was using these angry paramilitary clowns as some kind of front to kill Rodrigo. Rodrigo Branco was dead. Fabiana was held hostage. I had no idea who was behind any of this. I felt like a fool. I was a sweaty, gray-haired mess. This place was gonna kill me, too. I could see that now. I decided that I was gonna die sober, not drunk. At least then I would see who shot me. It was time to take back control from whoever was out to get me. And if I didn't flush them out, at least my midlife crisis would confuse them enough so they did something stupid. It was the only hope I had. I knew I wasn't thinking straight. I'd been drinking and popping painkillers for years. I had a liver like a French goose and skin like red leather. Well, it wasn't perfect. In fact, it wasn't much good at all, but it was gonna have to do. At least I was facing in the right direction.
Tá ligando, hein?
Alô?
Oh, Victor.
Max? Max, you're alive?
Of course I'm alive.
We did not know this. We are lost, Max. Our brother was everything to us.
I understand. Listen, I'm sorry about your loss. Both of you. Rodrigo was a good man. I failed him. But I was tricked.
What happened, Max?
I don't know.
Some guys from the crush of Prado came into the building downstairs, so while me and the security guard were dealing with them,
An assassin must have come in and executed your brother. At least that's how I think it happened.
No, you killed him, Boha. You killed my brother.
What are you talking about? I understand you're upset, but please, why the hell would I do that?
To get his money, to take his money.
How am I getting his money, Marcelo? Please, think. I worked my ass off for your family. I saved your life twice or more. Right now, I'm going to get Fabiana.
Where is she? Where is Fabiana, eh?
She's in a place called Nova Esperanza.
How do you know this, Max?
One of the Crotchet Praetor told me just before he died.
Please, bring our sister-in-law back to us, Max. Our family is being torn apart.
So I guess I was finally about to go and experience the other side of Sao Paulo firsthand. The bit people try to ignore. The unpleasant memory they try to obliterate with cocktails and helicopters and parties and lines of blow, like rich fools the world over. I was a day off the sauce for the first time in years and knew I was due a hangover sent direct from Mother Nature. I had no idea where the hell I was gonna go, so I decided to head straight for the street party that seemed to be raging. Either that or some other fool had gotten there before me and now was being ritually sacrificed. I've had better ideas, but then I've also had worse ones, like accepting this job in the first place.
E aí, gringo?
Que lost, kid.
Eu me amarro nos States. Você precisa de ajuda, senhor?
Speak English?
Aham, falo sim, sem problema.
I need to know if you ever seen this girl, Fabiana. Come here for a second, look at her.
I know lots of girls, sexy. Come on, come on. This way.
Where are you going? Wait a minute. Down there?
É isso.
Jesus.
At least I had found myself a tour guide. I had stumbled into some kind of street party. This was the kind of reality Americans paid top dollar to see. Slums had become tourist attractions, places where yuppies could gawk at the endless spirit of the poor from the inside of their bulletproof buses. I felt dumb and exposed. I missed the booze. Not that it mattered. Sober or drunk, I was hardly undercover. I stood out in this place like a streetwalker in a monastery.
Continua andando, caralho! Que porra é essa que você tá fazendo aqui? Como que você sai entrando aqui assim?
Anda, anda, vai pra lá!
What do you need, guys? What do you need?
O que você tá fazendo aqui? Eu tô te perguntando. Eu te chamei aqui, porra!
Easy, pal, easy.
Ah, então. Você é americano de merda.
Look, I didn't mean any offense.
Me dá só uma razão pra eu não te matar, seu americano burro.
Desculpa, amigo. Por favor.
Passa tudo que você tem, viado. Pega o dinheiro dele. Pega o dinheiro dele. Ah, relojão, hein? Passa aqui. Anda logo. Logo! Da puta! Valeu, mano! Bem-vindo à favela Nova Esperança! Agora não, fora daqui!
All things considered, I was gonna have to look on this as a good outcome. I was deep in gang territory.
Desculpa, olá.
Fala inglês. I'm a little lost. Perdido? Onde estou?
Tá no lugar errado, rapaz!
Não compreende. I need a phone, a telephone.
Bora.
Publico.
A gente não é centro de informação turística, não.
Well, they weren't gonna help me. and who could blame them? I was a dumb American in a place where dumb Americans were less popular than the clap. If I was gonna find my way out of this mess, I was on my own. When you're stuck in a foreign country and you don't know the words for reverse charges, and you're in some lonely skin joint in the middle of some poor slum, having just had every last cent robbed from you, and you call yourself a bodyguard, then you know you're a loser.
Hey, Matt, can I buy you a beer?
Do I know you?
I don't think so.
You're gonna shoot me. You make it quick, I'm a little busy.
If I was going to shoot you, I wouldn't waste a beer.
Wilson da Silva. Very good to meet you.
Nice to meet you, I think.
Although you'll forgive me if I promise never to employ you as my bodyguard. You did a great job watching after Rodrigo Branco.
Fuck you.
Let me ask you something. Have you ever seen this guy? Serrano.
Yep. He's a real sweetheart.
Yeah, he sure put his gang out of business. But don't worry, those guys, they're a small fry. This is the guy I'm interested in. Neves. And this is his little buddy here. Milo Hegel. They work for this vigilante group. Crasha Preto.
Yeah, I know him.
They're very popular with right-wing politicians. Like Victor Branco.
Rodrigo Branco?
Yes, he did some very bad things. Anyway, have you ever seen this guy?
Maybe at the stadium.
I knew you were involved in that business. You know, I wanted to investigate that, but I got an order to blame it on some local street kids instead. Tell me, what happened there?
Nothing. We simply went to hand over some cash to this guy's clowns for a ransom exchange when this guy's clowns jumped us and they shot everybody.
Apart from you and your boy Passos.
That's right. But we had to shoot our way out of there.
They let you go. It's okay, it's a little weird right now. But I know that Victor Branco is involved in all this. I just don't know how or why. And I know that the Ufe are involved in all this as well, but I just don't know how or why. And you know what's gonna happen? The moment is gonna come along when I put all these pieces together, and at that moment, someone is gonna come along and put a bullet in my head. I think you might want this.
Thank you. I'll need it.
And if it's Fabiana Branco you've come looking for, I think she's up the hill.
So why don't you just go get her?
I don't know. If I'm a cop, I mean, I'll fight corruption. I'll stand up to the rich and dumb, but if I go up that hill right now, I'll be dead in 3 minutes or less. Maybe you too, Max. If you survive the next hour, let's speak. You help me. And I'm gonna do what I can to help you. Good luck!
I didn't know what to make of what this guy had just told me. What was true and what was just someone else's convenient bullshit.
Hey, Green! O que você tá fazendo aí?
No comprende. Leave me alone.
Você tem alguma coisa pra mim?
Do you got something for me?
For you? I'll tell you what I got. I got a gun, and if anybody thinks they're gonna take it from me, they'd be dead wrong.
The fireworks display was clearly in my honor, making sure everyone knew to roll out the red carpet for their surprise guest. I could hear a woman screaming. I thought I'd found Fabiana, but instead I'd stumbled across some testosterone fest. A bunch of young punks with guns killing time the only way they knew how. Nova Esperanza wasn't exactly a dinner and movie kind of place. I recognized the hoods who jumped me earlier. I was trying to decide whether to crash this party or turn back, when my natural grace and finesse made the decision for me. These bastards looked different, tougher, more capable. They didn't look like Serrano's boys, but I could tell I was moving up the food chain. I hoped Fabiana wasn't going to be served up come feeding time. I couldn't find any clues in this place, so I decided to do my bit for the drugs trade. Hope the king was in his castle. As I approached the spot, I could hear raised voices. Then I saw that Marcello had turned up with a suitcase full of money along with Fabiano's sister, Giovanna. I only understood a little, but things were not going well. I wasn't expecting quite so many armed goons, but there was no backing out now. I would just have to act harder than I felt.
Put the guns down! Let the girls go. No one needs to die, asshole.
Toma no cu, seu gringo de merda. Vou matar.
Don't you kill her! Don't you!
Okay.
Here I was again, with all hell breaking loose around me, standing over another dead girl I had been trying to protect. We'd only been married a short time. By now, she had been dead longer than I knew her. I still hadn't really forgiven myself for the Mona business, but I knew that was just grief. The insanity that comes with losing the life you had built. Michelle, I missed her with every part of my being. I hated the world for not killing me with her, and I hated myself for allowing this to happen to her and our little girl.
Sorry, you just had to say goodbye.
You okay?
I will be once we get out of here. I get the feeling those weren't the only guys DeMarco sent after.
I got that feeling too.
I started to wonder if my luck was about to run out when I realized it had, a long time ago. That's why I was here. We'd come in here to hide, not very successfully as things turned out.
Freeze!
As opposed to what, disco dance?
Shut the fuck up, half-caste! Turn around! Turn around! Move! Move! Hold it! That way, you fucking jokers. Move!
Where are we going?
You killed my son.
You killed my fucking son. My boy. My only son.
Listen, I'm sorry.
Fuck you! Sorry for your loss. But your son was killed in gun battle. A battle he started.
Shut your fucking mouth! Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Fuck you! You killed my son! You fucking spick! God. You killed my son! Dig! Now!
I have to admit, I almost felt bad for the guy.
Dig!
Sure, he had lived a bad life, but I, of all people, knew that living with this grief would be payment enough for any sins. Still, perhaps not so bad that I was prepared to dig my own grave and let these Goombas kill me without even getting some dirt on their hands.
Your body ain't gonna bury itself. Dig, motherfucker!
Where are you going? I die!
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Follow me.
Hey, psst, this way. Up there. Go on. Go, go, go.
You can go first.
All right, gentlemen, thank you.
This place looks about as good as any to make a stand.
At least the coroner won't have to go far to go to work.
Like I said, Paso's always had a good sense of humor.
We gotta find a phone. I got a connection in Queens who can help us.
Huh. All right.
There's gotta be a landline in that office, man. I think we'll be all right.
Yeah, at least for a little while.
You just call somebody, get a little help, and we'll get out of here. Hey, hey, it's me. Look, we really need to get out of New Jersey. Yeah, the things are heating up. We got like half the New Jersey mob after us. And a cemetery in Hoboken.
Va! Va! Vai lá! Tranquilo! Tranquilo, pode ficar tranquilo. Fica nessa parede, seu americano de merda. Que porra tá acontecendo aqui? Que merda tá acontecendo aqui?
Haven't you figured out I don't speak your fucking language?
Seu gringo de merda, cala a boca, seu gringo.
That's right, I may be a moron. But here's the thing. I ain't quite as dumb as I seem.
It
It was time to get out of there. It seemed like someone had decided to carry out some impromptu justice on the street life below. The place was swarming with cops. They weren't there for me, as far as I could tell. And I'd blundered my way into enough clusterfucks for one day. If these fools could buy me some time, I might have a chance to get to Marcello and Giovanna before somebody put a bullet in their heads, too. Giovanna and Marcello were still alive, but I didn't hold out much hope they'd stay that way for long. I'd already lost the ransom money, got the hostage killed, and I was only just getting started. This was turning into another fine example of private security work. I'd heard about these raids. Rent-a-thugs in body armor sending a message to the poor that the cops are still in charge. When they hit the favelas, they came in hard and fast. Anyone was fair game, as I was about to find out. Jesus Christ, these bastards weren't playing games. These were the same paramilitary cops I had seen executing fools after the failed kidnapping at the party. Nasty business. If these were the guys De Silva was worried about, maybe he had a point. Yes, this was definitely them. The alley was a dead end in more ways than one. I needed to find a way out of there. It seemed like as good a place as any to lie low and get my bearings. Problem was, some other fine gentleman had the same idea. I'd gone from out of luck to unarmed and shit out of luck. Another reminder, not that I needed one, that any low point can always go lower, as my new friends were about to find out. It was São Paulo's finest and a busload of lucky winners they picked out earlier. I decided I might as well follow them. I was lost and they were going somewhere. And it was the closest I was going to get to a plan. Where were they taking them? Did they have Marcello and Giovanna? Was this just an average favela raid or something more? When all you're left with is questions, I guess your only option is to go with your gut. And my gut was telling me that band of merry men would lead me to some answers. Answers I'd soon wish I'd never received. What was going on here? They looked like the same paramilitaries from the stadium and office attacks. Something felt wrong. In fact, everything felt wrong. Anytime those guys decided to join the party, you could be sure it wasn't going to end in a piñata and a slice of cake. What the fuck was this? The vigilantes doing an exchange with the death squad cops? Were they buying people? What the hell for? None of this made too much sense. These two were serious operatives. One was a band of hired killers and the other supposed to keep the peace. Yet they were doing deals. Now I had to find Giovanna and Marcello. Without a better plan, I thought I'd better follow this bastard.
Faz isso não, viu? Por favor, não faça isso não!
Vamos acabar com essa porra! Cala a boca, sua puta! Vem pra cá!
Here was Giovanna and Marcello. What the hell were they about to do to him?
Marcello!
Help!
acontecendo?
Filho da puta! Você tá fugindo, gringo!
Bastard!
Javon! We're gonna be okay. No, 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 no! You don't want to do that! Come on! Go, 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 go! Why did they do that to Marcelo?
It's a legendary gangway of killing people.
These are no ordinary street gang.
I guess they want people to think they are. With this, they can justify the killings of today and the people they took.
Shh. Quem fez isso?
Foi americano.
Foi?
Foi?
He's blaming you for the death of his friend.
Porra de americano.
Cruzão morre, porra.
Caralho. Contra ele. Mata ele!
Pode deixar, eu mato!
After a couple of hours of lying in shit, you learn to appreciate what you've got, and right now all we had was each other. I was a wreck, and Giovanna, well, I knew what she'd seen no amount of drugs or therapy could erase. That kind of pain follows you around forever, the constant shadow of a wasted life. The poor girl had been through enough. We had to find a way out of there. Giovanna was calling Passos. I didn't know if this was a good place to hide or not. When half the local police force and a crew of paramilitary psychopaths want to send you upstairs, I reasoned the crowd was as good a place as any. At least when we got shot, maybe some kind soul would take a video and put it on the internet.
Let's go. I just saw a cop looking at me.
All right.
Russell said there's a good place to hide in the back.
I'm just trying to stay calm. Come on, come on, come on. You okay?
Yeah.
Let's go.
I guess this is it.
No, keep going. That's a girl.
Passos, you call him. We just want to live somewhere, away from this shit.
I understand. I wanted that too, a long time ago.
What happened?
Just didn't work out that way.
Sorry to hear that.
Maybe things will be different. For you two, I mean. Passos is a lucky guy.
Stay
right here while I check it out. Make sure you stay out of sight.
Oh my God. Max!
Come on.
What's going on? What's going on?
I don't know, but we gotta get the hell out of here. Let's go.
We're not going to make it, are we?
We'll be fine. We just gotta lay low till Passos gets here.
This wasn't looking good. What the hell were Giovanna and Marcello thinking going in there by themselves? Guess their plan was no more idiotic than mine, and I couldn't really fault them for losing faith in the Broncos' security detail.
Let me just check this. We need to get out of the open.
A barely recovering alcoholic and an unarmed pregnant woman. We were hardly a SEAL team. I put our life expectancy at 5 minutes.
Hey,
if we were lucky.
If you can lift me up there, I'll see if I can lower it down.
All right. Ready? Go. Got it.
Giovanna was a brave girl. She wasn't giving up. And I guess that meant neither could I.
Well done.
Janelle.
Stay close and keep quiet. God damn it!
Na sacada!
Now get down!
Next room?
Yes, I think so.
Well, that may be our best bet. Go on, I'll meet you there.
Are you sure?
Yeah, don't worry. I'll find a way through. Just stay quiet and keep down.
Max! 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 I can't see a way down here either.
Has to be something. Those stairs down.
Wait a second. I'm going to try something.
Good.
Should we wait here for Passos?
No, it's not safe enough. Come on.
Max!
Quiet!
You're the one breaking in.
No, you're the one breaking in. Come on. Get your leg up. Got it? Open the door.
I haven't.
Ever shot anybody?
No.
Well, it's drive or shoot, sister. Right now, I reckon I'll be better at the shooting. Come on, you can do this. All right, now listen to me. When I give you the word, I want you to slam it into gear, full on the gas. Drive us the hell out of here.
Oh, no!
It's all right.
right, try to concentrate.
Look, Basil.
Just drive. Hold on.
Get up to the roof of this building and get the passos. Tell them to wait for me. Now go. Jump. Go.
Just about to run to the roof when my savior and friend, the man whose unborn child I had just killed for, decided to leave without me.
Boy, Max! Get in! Quick!
I can't believe that bastard just flew off on me. After everything we've been through, I saved his girlfriend's life.
Who? Raul Passos?
Yeah, Raul Passos.
Yeah, I know. I thought you guys were very close.
We were.
Well, you know what? I did a background check.
Jesus.
I mean, I thought the two of you worked for Rodrigo Branco.
Yeah, so?
So? Did you get paid by Victor?
Victor? No.
Well, Raul Passos did. 6 times. Dating back to a few months before you turned up. He even paid for a ticket for him to go to New York.
Why?
I don't know. My guess is to meet you.
But why?
I don't know. Maybe he liked you. Maybe he thought you needed a break.
That's funny.
I don't know. Maybe he wanted some dumb gringo to come down here to shoot things up and maybe to take the watch for Rodrigo when he got shot.
I don't believe that.
Why? Because you're not a dumb gringo? Or because you are?
You know, I have no fucking clue anymore.
Okay. Let me ask you something.
What?
Well, what is it that you really thought that you were doing down there in Panama? Hmm? And don't tell me you're so naive as to think you were just down there guarding a woman.
I didn't know what to say. I had been so loaded in Panama, I could scarcely remember my own name. I know things had got real heavy. Panama had been my second job with Passos.
Hey, Max! Max! Come on!
The first had been easy. Money for banging waitresses at some fancy wedding in the Caribbean. This seemed like another easy gig. It was the middle of the day, and like any self-respecting idiot, I was half cut.
Nothing like doing some good blow, some good friends on a boat. Nasty! Come here, I love this one.
Marcello, you're going to be the death of me. Sombrero Mortar.
Sure beats New Jersey, huh, Max?
Some ways.
Hey, come on, it's awesome.
Drunk and tan, listening to house music. Most of them have plastic surgery and they're all doing blow. I guess it is kind of like Jersey, huh?
That's really funny, Max. Hey, so!
Oh. drinking so much. Give myself serious liver damage.
Big deal. You can always get a new one. Relax.
I hope you're not drinking on the job, Jen.
I'm kidding. I hope you are.
Just stay off the air, hmm? I don't have enough to share.
I'm kidding again. Oh, Mikey. Even though we just met, I feel like we are good friends, you know? Mm.
I feel like safe with you guys. Know that. Real safe.
That's great.
And I love New York. The East Hamptons. Do you know it?
Not really. I spent my honeymoon in Montauk.
Oh, where's that?
It's just down the road.
Whatever. Last time I was there, I got so wasted, I nearly shit myself. I didn't know you were married.
Yeah, well, my wife passed away.
Good. Not good. Bad. Real bad. But good, because now I can get you laid a lot. It is great to be single, hey? I love a woman. She's with another and she doesn't want to know it. Fuck her. I mean, could you believe that shit?
Okay.
Excuse me, I'm going to go to speak to Felipe. Felipe! You crazy crackhead, lay off the yayo, eh?
Pasos.
Welcome in.
What's the deal with this guy, eh? He's kind of stuck up.
He's a good guy.
Sure, tá bom, but have him smile a bit more, you know?
His life is good!
Where's the truck?
It's coming.
Hey, soon.
Pasos. I gotta go lay down.
Okay.
The need to get out of the boat's hull and onto the upper deck as soon as possible was countered by the probability of running into another hijacker. I had to move carefully. The guys up ahead weren't dealing with passengers like the rest of them. Maybe I should have realized then that this was no ordinary kidnap job. Something on the boat had attracted the sharks. I spotted Passos and Marcelo. If I'd known back then that they'd been up to no good while I was fighting my way through a band of violent paramilitaries and a worse hangover, I might not have wanted to get over to them so bad.
Hey, Passos!
At the time, I hadn't thought too much about this. I hadn't thought too much about anything. Now I remember it. It didn't seem quite so kosher.
What about, what's her name? Daphne.
Do whatever you think is best.
I think it's best we try to go find her.
Yeah, okay, let's go. Yeah.
See, I didn't think Passos was a bad guy. He didn't need to try to save this woman or the crew.
We're here.
I didn't realize you knew your way around here. They were using that building to get across the canal. Jesus Christ.
Fuck, man. This is brutal. I didn't think things would be like this.
I should have jumped in that goddamn canal myself and swum my way back to New York.
What do you think you were really doing in Panama?
I was drinking.
People died. Innocent people. Who do you think robbed you?
I don't know. I was told it was people who disliked Daphne Bernstein. Something about an unpleasant divorce.
Her ex-husband worked on Wall Street. Do you think he has easy access to Panamanian death squads?
Guess I didn't really think about it.
You were smuggling something, weren't you?
No. I mean, I didn't realize it at the time. I didn't think too much about it, but yes, Marcelo did drive off with something. I don't know what. I didn't see him until we got to Brazil a week or so later.
I think it was money. I think Marcelo and Victor have a friendly banker there in Panama. Your little cruise was to deliver the cash to him, because there it's easier to launder.
But I thought the Broncos were rich.
Rodrigo's rich. The other two, they live well, but they don't have real money. Victor's campaigns were always financed by his brother. That is the way among certain rich families there. The eldest brother is the king. You know, he gets everything. The other two, not so much.
And now Rodrigo's dead.
Exactly. And Marcelo, too. It's an awful tragedy for Victor, huh? A man running on a law and order ticket, you know, whose brothers have both been killed in such terrible circumstances.
A true patriot. What about Marcelo?
Marcelo was an idiot. Were this true, I certainly don't believe he could possibly have known about it. But I do believe some other scheme, you know, some other bullshit. Whatever that cash was, Victor could have talked him into something. I don't know yet.
And Passos?
Well, Passos is a bum ex-cop. He failed in America, failed in São Paulo. He was surrounded by more money and more poverty than his tiny little head can handle. You think guys like that can't be bought?
No, but if...
But nothing. He's probably not a bad guy. He's just a man caught in the crossfire of a very rich family.
What about me?
You. You're the fall guy. The American. Running around, acting like the action hero. Killing lots of people. You're a stroke of genius.
That ain't how it is.
You were an angry ex-cop. You were sitting in a bar with a history of violence and a history of a bad temper. You were perfect.
Me and Passos went to the academy together.
Did you?
I don't fucking know.
Okay, let's take a drive, Max. You want to do some good? Want to get yourself killed in a good cause? Then I need you to check something out for me.
Like what?
That incident at the favela today. Now, some of my officers say a bus drove off some captives.
They did, I saw.
But no captives were ever booked.
They probably handed them off to the paramilitary death squads, the,
Caixa Preto?
Right.
Who did?
I don't know, the cops. The other cops, the cops who shoot on sight.
The UFE.
Right.
Max, you see that building there?
The Imperial Palace Hotel?
Yeah, that's what it says. People go in there, in large groups, under armed guard. But it isn't a police station, and no one comes out of there.
Why don't you just go in and bust the joint, get a warrant?
I'm only a cop, Max.
So you keep saying. Time to find out what was going on here. I didn't fancy booking myself in the presidential suite, so went looking for the basement. I wasn't too excited about the acoustics in this place. A couple of gunshots would sound like I'd walked in here with a goddamn marching band. It wasn't pretty, but I guess none of what was about to happen was gonna be. The Imperial Palace Hotel was a five-star bona fide shithole. I needed to find out why guests were checking in by the busload and checking out by the bagload. Maybe the service would be better upstairs. That deal at the favela was getting dirtier by the minute. Those bastards were clearly in bed with the Crasha Prado. Now I just had to find out why. Starting with a bit of bedtime reading for Mr. Da Silva. When you've lived the kind of life I've lived, reality comes at you through a different lens. But nothing could have prepared me for what was on the other side of that door. I had to get those poor bastards out of there.
Get them out of here. Go. Go. Wait. I said get Serrano.
Serrano. He looked pathetic. A man defeated. I walked away and left him to his own personal nightmare. Whatever hell this was Da Silva had sent me into, I knew I had to put an end to it.
What the fuck is going on here?
How much do you want?
What have you been doing?
I am a doctor. I help people.
What have you been doing here?
It's easy for you. Listen, I know people. They will kill you. I can help you. Trust me. Please, please.
What have you been doing?
I have a lot of money. Look, look. Lots of money. I do important research. Please.
Caralho! Caralho!
Espera, espera, eu posso explicar tudo. Tudinho! amor de Deus, por favor, não me mata. Não, não. Pelo amor de Deus.
E aí, doutor?
They had a fucking arsenal in here. It was time to bring this little hellhole to the ground, so I decided to put some of their C4 to good use. Was the last of the explosives. I just hoped it was enough to bring down the building and all the evil in it.
Vai, vai, rápido, rápido, vai!
Who wants to take a shot? You see what this is? Come on, anybody? Wanna be a hero? I got nothing to lose, let's do it!
Que porra que tá acontecendo aqui?
Senhor Neves!
What the fuck is your problem, man?
My problem? My problem? Wanna know what my problem is? You're turning humans into glue! That's what my fucking problem is!
I don't know what you're talking about, American. All I know is what I hear about you. You bodyguard for the Brancos. They are all dead. You help the poor. Today, many of them dead. You are a proper American hero.
At least I fucking tried.
Well done with your effort. The whole city is grateful. The great American savior of the poor.
That's right.
You think you made any difference? You think stopping this legitimate business venture is helping anyone?
Legitimate? You're stealing people's organs!
We pay for everything! We have the record!
Oh, so people can sell their livers, their hearts, their eyeballs? You're insane, you sick fuck!
We kept people safe in the city! Decent people! Safe! I know a lot of powerful people.
Well, your powerful people aren't gonna help you out of this one, buddy.
City was dangerous, friend.
I kinda like it. It's growing on me.
Nice to see a happy tourist smiling.
The fuck are you doing here?
I came back.
I can see that. Why?
To save you.
Oh, yeah, real hero.
Listen,
now come with me, Max. To Brazil. A chance to play the fall guy in a plot that my boss's brother's hatching to profit from the selling of human organs. Yeah, it'll be perfect for you.
What are you talking about? I know nothing about human organs, man. Victor and Marcelo are trying to teach Rodrigo a lesson. Get into losing the purse strings and the family money. They pressured me into doing it. You wanna die? I came back for you. I did my best. I'm having a kid, Max. I gotta go.
Fuck you.
Sure. Later. Now, let's go. This thing works.
I owe you everything.
No, you don't. I'm sorry I couldn't save your sister.
I was there. It wasn't your fault.
I was paid to protect her, and I didn't.
She married into a sick family.
Maybe.
I just wanted to say thank you for giving us a chance to live. I mean, as a family.
I hope it all works out for you, for all of you.
Thank you. Don't be too long.
Well, buddy, that's it.
Where are you guys gonna go?
I don't know, maybe back to New York, maybe down to Argentina. Giovanna has family in Salvador. Maybe we'll just stay there.
Yeah, I got business to take care of.
I'm sorry I dragged you into this. I know it was very wrong.
It's all right, it's done. And hey, I'm having myself a fun old time. Maybe this is how things had to be. Figure I might as well die in the sunshine as die in the snow.
Look, I'm sorry I'm leaving. I got a kid coming. You know how it is.
I know how that is.
You know, I almost didn't say goodbye to you. I said to myself, maybe this guy will put a bullet in me.
Maybe I will. But not right now.
Thank you. Try to look after yourself, Max, huh? Life is worth living.
If you say so, pal.
I thought I was going to have to witness another murder.
Nah. Not him.
You ready?
I guess.
Okay. I've looked through this information you gathered. It's not very nice.
What is it?
It's the Ufe. The famous Mr. Becker.
Friend of Victor Branco.
Yes. And a contributor to his campaigns. A government employee, of course.
And?
A weapons dealer. A murderer. This was known. A dealer in human organs. This wasn't known.
A proper gentleman.
Sure.
So you're gonna bring him down?
Yes, because I want to lose my wife and my children and then get killed myself. All that after watching him walk free.
Tell me what has to be done.
Well, officially, there's nothing I can do.
And unofficially?
Well, we can always try something a little more creative.
Creative? De Silva had promised me a 10 o'clock showcase. I had to make sure I was on stage and ready for my close-up.
Diga a Becker. Que vim para ele. Ah!
Cara aí,
manda tua conta, rapaz.
Vai, fudeu! Meu conto eu quero saber do cu, pô.
Ela não desgruda dela, meu.
Ei, quem é essa cara aí?
Convidado nosso.
Quebra esse otário aí.
Deixa comigo, me dá uma lição nele.
Então, o pai dela não desgruda.
Patrão, filha da puta!
Atrás de inocentes!
Mas que
você vai fazer com aqui?
Eu não fiz nada!
O que você vai acontecer, caralho? Tá pensando o quê? Hã?
Onde é que você vem?
Fica aí, cara!
Eu!
Se fodeu, filha da puta!
Otário!
Vai, olha
aí, otário! Deixa eu sair daqui, velho!
Ô, segura a porta aí!
Eu vi uma outra versão.
Ainda mais ouvir aquela parada lá, hein?
Demorou.
Chega aí.
Aí, amigo.
Hey! What are you doing here? Huh? I asked you a question.
Answer him! Answer him!
What are you doing?
What?
What are you doing here?
O que você está fazendo aqui?
What are you doing here?
I don't understand. I can't hear you.
What are you doing here?
What are you doing here?
Me in the ear.
Hey, answer me. What are you doing here?
Oh.
guess our little stunt helped some other civic-minded people raise valid concerns about community relations. Their faces said it all. I was on their side, but how could they know that? If they came through that door, I'd be leaving as a human shield and never leaving at all. Luckily for me, for once the police arrived just in time. There it was, the tape from the Bronco security system. Jesus, it was that guy. I had seen him in the favela. Bachmeier, Becker's right-hand man. His time would come. Him and Becker. This was the passkey to Becker's office. I was close to the end of all this, and I could feel it.
Becker!
Something funny about dying?
I felt like the avenging angel. I looked like a fat bald dude with a bad temper.
You disgusting piece of shit! I know everything!
Not everything, my friend. Let go of him, Max.
Huh?
There's a good fellow.
Well, well, well. Victor, I was wondering when you'd reappear out of whatever slimy hole you live in.
I'd like to just say, Max, I just want to say thank you for all your hard work, for my family, and for cleaning up that horrible mess with the Crasha Preto for us. You know I'm tough on crime. I give you a bonus. But I think you just frittered it away. Becker, take his gun.
Thomas, you feel the poop!
They had barred the door. My only hope was to chase them down. I knew they'd be leaving town, and my guess is they would try to fly out of here. Rich people love to fly away.
God damn it!
Okay, Max. Now you check the main terminal. I'm gonna go and look for the Bronco plane by the hangar, okay?
Let's do it.
You keep an eye out in there. You know Becker's gonna have some guys in there watching out for you.
Yep.
So, of course, I knew they were looking for me. But the airport was about the only place a fat gringo might blend in. Well, there or a sex club. My delusions of disguise lasted around 2 seconds. They were out in force. And they were out for me. But then, I was out for them, too. Every last one of those bastards.
Check in.
And we were off. I felt like I might be able to recharge for a second. At least until we pulled into the station and met more murderous assholes. Out on the joke, and it was a real good one. Come on. Ah! taken me right into the heart of it. Becker's gimps were everywhere, so he and Branco must be close. The smart move would have been sticking with De Silva and going straight to the hangar, but when was I ever about smart moves? I'm a dumb move guy. Hey, Max, we'll drive onto the runway. No thanks. Let me walk in the main entrance. I'll put a big shit-eating grin on my face and let these assholes take turns trying to kill me. That's my style, and it's too late in the day to hope for change. Boy, were they throwing numbers at this problem. But then, I'd chosen to be here. I wanted this. Was it redemption? Not really. It was pathetic desperation, and not much else. The further in I got, the more guys I saw. Becker wasn't running a police force. He was running an army. These guys were better trained and better equipped than anyone I'd seen out here. And I'd seen some mean sons of bitches. The mission was screaming suicide, but I didn't give a damn. At least I'd die being a pain in the ass. There the bastards were, sneaking off in their rich kid's toy.
I ain't got nowhere else to go, Becker!
Mr. Payne, I believe you had something to say to me. Mate ele! Mate ele agora! Não! Não! Não!
This was it. It was almost over. So I guess I'd become what they wanted me to be. A killer. Some rent-a-clown with a gun who puts holes in other bad guys. Well, that's what they had paid for, so in the end, that's what they got. Say what you want about Americans, but we understand capitalism. You buy yourself a product and you get what you pay for. And these chumps had paid for some angry gringo without the sensibilities to know right from wrong. Here I was, about to execute this poor bastard like some dime store angel of death, and I realized they were correct. I wouldn't know right from wrong if one of them was helping the poor and the other was banging my sister. One card left to play.
Just get me close. That's them.
Asshole.
Don't worry. Border's closed.
Let him enjoy a trial and a spell in prison. Let him suffer. Trust me.
You know I walk.
You'll walk with a limp!
The 55th Battalion.
9 of the City Police's Special Forces Unit who have been implicated in human trafficking has been disbanded indefinitely. Meanwhile, Victor Branco, the politician at the center of the scandal, who is accused of laundering money from the scheme to fund his political campaign for mayor, was yesterday found hanged in his police cell. It's not yet clear whether his death was a suicide or simply retribution for his part in a scandal that has so many families missing loved ones that were kidnapped and killed. City officials say a full investigation
local
is
justice.
Underway. Local residents expressed outrage as if they have been let down by both law enforcement and city leaders. And now, your local forecast. Boy, it's dark in some places, but it's sunny everywhere else. Over to Marisol with the weather.